Dear student, now I give lecture on die line oscillation of a two area system. The previous section and all, the system state matrix 9 into 9 matrix for two area system we studied. With some simplification, we can get a fairly good idea of the effect of the system parameters on the dynamic response. Dynamic response means the parameter changes with respect to time only. Now, let us make the following assumption made. First one is neglect turbine and governor time constant. Second assumption is neglect damping constants D1 and D2. The D1 and D2 is nothing but the damping constant. The third assumption is both areas are identical. So, these three assumptions we made, then we can derive the die line oscillations equations for two area system. With these assumptions, the two area equations reduced to del P M1 of S equal to minus del omega 1 of S divided by R. Then del P M2 of S is equal to del minus del omega 2 of S divided by R. Therefore, the del omega 1 of S equal to 1 divided by 2 HS into del P M1 of S minus del P L1 of S minus del P 1 2 of S. Substituting Pm1 of S, now we get del omega 1 of S equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by 2 RHS into minus del PL1 of S minus del P12 of S divided by 2 H of S. Similarly, we get omega 2 of S for area 2. Del omega 2 of S equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by 2 or HS into minus del PL2 of S plus del P12 of S divided by 2 H of S. Del P12 of S equal to T divided by S into del omega 1 of S minus del omega 2 of S. Therefore, T by S into 1 divided by 1 plus 1 divided by 2 or HS into 1 divided by 2 HS into del PL2 of S minus del PL1 of S minus 2 del P12 of S. That is del P12 of S into 1 divided 1 plus 2T divided by 2 H squared plus S by R in equal to T divided by 2 H squared plus S by R into del P L2 of S minus del P L1 of S. Or del P12 of S equal to T divided by 2 H the whole divided by S squared plus S divided by 2 R H plus T by H into del P L2 of S minus del P L1 of S. The above equation we have to convert it into the like that quadratic equation like that we can come and all. That is the equation number 15. So, therefore, the poles of the denominator, that is the denominator mean S squared plus S divided by 2 R H plus T by H, the denominator. This is the pole of the, this is the second order response system only. Second order system. So, the poles of the denominator determine the oscillations in del P12. So, we compare the denominator with the standard second order characteristics equation. S squared plus 2 alpha S plus omega n squared, that is equal to S squared plus 2 zeta omega n S plus omega n squared. So now we can see that alpha equal to 1 divided by 4 RH and omega n equal to root of T divided by H per unit or root of 2 pi F naught T divided by H radian per second. The omega n is the damping ratio. So the damping is determined by the relative values of alpha and omega n and the roots of the equation number 15 are S1, S2 equal to minus zeta omega n plus or minus j omega n root of 1 minus sigma square, the sigma square, zeta squared. Therefore, where alpha equal to zeta omega n only. And omega d equal to omega n into root of 1 minus zeta squared. Alpha is called the damping factor or damping constant. Omega n is the natural undamped frequency of oscillation. Omega d is called the damped or conditional frequency. And the zeta is called the damping ratio. We now have the following cases. First cases we can consider. Suppose when zeta, that is the damping ratio equal to 1 or damping factor alpha equal to omega n. This condition is called the critical damping. So dyline oscillation. Dyline, what is the purpose of dyline? Dyline is used to that interchange power from one area to another area. Oscillation, we have to find the oscillation. When under critical damping, what are the oscillation? Under damping, over damping conditions, we can calculate the oscillation. So the first case, when zeta, that is a damping ratio equal to 1 or damping factor alpha equal to omega n. This condition is called the critical damping. The second one is when zeta, that is the damping ratio equal to 0 or alpha equal to 0. The roots are purely imaginary and we get purely sinusoidal oscillation for the step change input. So when damping ratio equal to 0 or alpha equal to 0, the roots are purely imaginary and we get purely sinusoidal oscillation for a step change in input. In equation 14, the input is del PL of 2S minus del PL1 of S. Therefore, for a step change in load, step change means del PL1, that is change in the load, we would get sustained sinusoidal oscillation of dyline power at a frequency of omega n. From equation 16, we can see that alpha equal to 0 and r equal to infinity. This means that there is no governor speed control. When alpha less than omega n, zeta less than 1, we get a pair of complex conjugate roots. The system is underdamped and we have oscillation in dyline power flow which have the frequency omega d as in equation 19 only. The time constant of the system is 1 by alpha. The fourth condition is cases is when alpha greater than omega n, we have an overdamped system. The roots are both real. The above analysis is only approximate, but it is helpful in knowing the effect of the choice of parameters on the stability of the system. If we consider the damping constants of the load, then alpha is modified as alpha equal to 1 divided by 4H d plus 1 by r. That from the dyline oscillation, the second order response under overdamped condition, under damped condition and then critical conditions what is the roots, that is the time constant, and then what is the roots of the second order response we studied. This is the timeline oscillation for the two area system.